my mind. And every time I get that same feeling in me.
Don Devinish, first vice president of the Banking Insurance and General Workers Union. Today the workers of First Citizens Bank are demonstrating in front of their head office against the false proposals that the bank has proposed to them. Bank failure to properly compensate these workers. The bank did their own survey, which shows that the workers in the professional stream were below the market by between $1,000 and $1,400. However, their proposals of 3%, 3% and 2%, which is a total of 8% over the 3-year period starting from 2012 to 2014, does not bring them up to the market. For instance, a supervisor whose salary is of $8,924, applying the increase of the 3%, 3% and 2% over the 3-year period will result in a salary of $9,846. However, the market salary at the end of 2014 result is $11,163, showing a deficit of $113. That is $1,300. That is, the bank is still way below the market. It's not only below the market, but the market has continued to move away from the bank. These workers of First Citizens Bank are the most productive workers in the financial sector. For the, over the last 6 years, from 2007 to 2012, they have caused the bank to earn in excess of $3.5 billion. So much so that Ms. Neri Afonso, the chairperson of the board of directors for First Citizens Bank, was boasting that the bank is swimming in dough. These very same workers, however, the bank is refusing.
Two by two, with a free life.